Hi guys, welcome back again to my channel Knowledge Booster TV. Today I have come up with another topic of Pearson test of English, which is called summarize written text. I hope this video will be useful for you. So what is summarize written text? In summarize written text, your main two skills will be tested in PTE, that is called reading, and another skill will be writing, because you will be given one small text which would be around 100, 200 or 300 words, and then you have to read that topic and you have to make a summary in one sentence of that topic. So you have to read it nicely so that you will get all the important points, and then you have to write it nicely so that all those important points will be covered. So you will be basically given 2 to 3 summarized written text, and for each task, for each text, for each summarized written text, you will have 10 minutes to write one sentence summary. And always remember, you should write summary in one sentence, and that one sentence should be from 5 to 75 words. If you write less than 5 words, then it will be given 0 marks, and if you write more than 75 of words, it will be again given 0 marks. So preferably the best sentence will be around 30 to 40 words, so that you will have a good command in writing simple yet complex sentence, not very simple and not very complex sentence, and you can easily control the flow of that sentence. So out of those 10 minutes for each task, first 2 minutes you should give for preparation, like skimming through text, knowing all those important points about that text, and then next 5 minutes you should do writing, including all those important points and making the sentence look nice without any grammatical errors. And next 2 to 3 minutes you should always plan for checking grammar and editing that sentence, because if you make small errors in that sentence, then you will be deducted marks. So it's better to write plain and simple sentence rather than doing many mistakes in that sentence. So you should always plan last 2 to 3 minutes for checking your sentence, and as it is a sentence, just one sentence, and you should always start that sentence with capital letter, and you should always end that sentence with full stop. If you forget to put full stop, or if you forget to start with capital letter, then you will be deducted marks for grammar. So remember all the rules of the sentence. So you should remember some of the important parts of the sentences, such as conjunction. And conjunction includes examples like if, when, and, thus, so, however, which, because you are writing a sentence which should include all those important points of that text. You cannot write a very simple sentence, and that simple sentence cannot include all those important points. So you should have some good command over the grammatical things, such as conjunction. And conjunction includes those words like if, when, and thus, so, however, which, when, who. So if you can make a good use of those sentences, you will be able to include many points from that written summary, from that text which is given to you, and which is always good, because you can include as many points as possible in a very nice and precise way. So before going to actual PTE test, you should make yourself familiar with these words, which is extremely important, and I have given you one of the links which will help you to master in that skill, like use of conjunction. It is not only about conjunction, it has many other aspects of grammar, and you can always find those nice links in Google and try to read more about grammar, which is always helpful in this kind of task. So I am giving you one of the example which includes conjunction and complex part of the sentence. So if I read this, it looks like biology, then comma, which. So which is a conjunction here. So biology, I have start with capital B, always remember to start with capital B. So biology, Which is the most popular subject in Australia. So this part, this whole part, which is the most popular subject in Australia, can simply be removed from this sentence. But this part is describing biology. So so this part, if I include this part, which is the most popular subject in Australia, I may be able to demonstrate that I have a good understanding of the grammatical areas in English. So I'll always get higher marks, higher score. So biology, which is the most popular subject in Australia, is taken by more than 30,000 students per year. So this sentence, from biology to per year, is already complete. But again, I am using a semicolon here, and then I am using another conjunction here. However, so however, the job prospects are diminishing due to the high intake every year. So this sentence is able to include so many points by itself. So you can just write this sentence like biology is taken by more than 30,000 students per year, but that sentence will be very simple and it will not be able to include those points like the most popular subject and the job prospects are diminishing. So you should have some command in using complex complex sentence, and I'll show you two examples of summarizing written text, which will show you how to use those conjunction and how to include all those important points from the text which is given to you. So this is example one. So I'll just read it. By far the most popular and most consumed drink in the world is water. So it looks like this paragraph is talking about water, but we don't know because we haven't read other parts of the paragraph. But it may come as no surprise that the second most popular beverage is tea. So both water and tea are included here. So we don't know until now. So we should quickly go through the text. Although tea was originally grown only in certain parts of Asia, now it looks like it is more inclining towards tea. So this paragraph might be about tea. So although tea was originally grown in certain parts of Asia, in countries as China, Burma and India, it is now a key export product in more than 50 countries around the globe. Countries that grow tea, however, need to have right tropical climate, which includes up to 200 centimeters of rainfall per year to encourage fast growth, and temperatures that range from 10 to 35 degrees centigrade. They also need to have quite specific geographical features such as high altitude to promote the flavor and taste of the tea, and land that can offer plenty of shade in the form of other trees and vegetation to keep the plants cool and fresh. Together, these conditions contribute to the production of the wide range of high quality teas that are in such huge demand among the world's consumers. There is green tea, jasmine tea, Earl Grey tea, peppermint tea to help you sleep, tea to promote healing, and tea to relieve stress. But above all, tea is a social drink that seems to suit the palates and consumption habits of human beings in general. So I just read this paragraph quickly. So you should read this paragraph in about 1 to 2 minutes, and you should be able to note down the important points from this paragraph. So I can say that this paragraph is talking about tea because it is not talking about water, although it started from water. So this paragraph is talking about tea. I have highlighted important points in the red. So this paragraph is talking about tea, which is the second most popular beverage. So you should include this part, as this paragraph is mentioning that tea is the second most popular. And this paragraph mentions about tea, which is second most popular drink, because this is the key export product in more than 50 countries around the globe. So these two parts means tea is one of the most popular or second most popular drink in the world. And also, if you go to next part of the paragraph, it is saying the conditions which is required to have a nice tea to grow, such as right tropical climate, right temperature, and right geographical features. So you should include those points in your summary. You don't need to include like 200 centimeters or 35 degrees or high altitude, because you cannot include everything in your sentence. But if you include right climate and temperature and geographical features, that will automatically be considered as you are including all those points, because those are minor details and these are major details. So right tropical climate is major detail and 200 centimeter is minor detail. So you don't need to include 200 centimeter or 35 degree or high altitude, but you should include right climate, right temperature and right geographical features. And another important point which is included in this paragraph is tea will help you sleep, tea will promote healing, and tea will help you to relieve stress, which means tea is important from your health point of view, and tea is also a social drink. So the major points, major details of this paragraph is tea, which is very popular, and tea requires right climate and right geographical features to have a very nice growth of tea, and tea is used for both health purpose and tea is used as a social drink throughout the world. So I'll give you a summary of this paragraph. So you can write the summary in a simple way or more complex way. Although this simple is also not like very simple, but I'm just giving you example so that it will be easy for you to follow. Those persons who have very good command in grammar or English can you follow more complex, but those persons who are very beginner, very new to PTE, they can follow simple sentences so that it will be easy for them. So if you write it in a simple way, I already said that there are 4 or 5 points which you should include to get higher score. So this paragraph is talking about tea. So I started with tea, capital letter T here. So tea, which requires appropriate climatic and geographical features to grow. So I started with tea, which is one detail of this paragraph. And then another detail, another major topic, major point of this paragraph is tea requires appropriate climatic and geographical features. And I'm using the word which. If I don't use the word which here, then I won't be able to describe about tea. So I need to know how to use which, and this will help you to write the complex or good sentence, which is always liked by PTE examiners. So tea, which requires appropriate climatic and geographical features to grow, is the second most popular drink in the world after water. So I'm again including another point, another important point of that paragraph. Because I have to link another point of that paragraph, because it is not only used for health purpose but also is a part of social drink. So from this sentence I am able to include all those points, all those 5 important points which were mentioned in that paragraph. So I am including about tea, I'm including about the conditions which are required for tea to grow, such as appropriate climatic and geographical features, and I'm also including that tea is the second most popular drink in the world after water, because it is not only used for health purpose. So health purpose, I already said I don't need to include the minor details, but I can, if I include health purpose, that will include tea will be used for relieving stress, tea will be used to induce sleep, and also I included another point like tea is also a part of social drink. So this is how you can write that paragraph in a simple way, and if you write it in a slightly more complex way, then you can write like this. So I'm starting with tea again, tea capital, tea comma the second most popular drink in the world. So I included another point, I included one point which is tea, another point is the second most popular drink in the world, is grown in many countries, that is another point, but these countries need to have special geographical and climatic conditions to produce high quality tea. So I already included 3-4 points. So tea, one point, the second most popular drink in the world, another major point of that paragraph, is grown in many countries, another major point, but these countries need to have special geographical and climatic conditions to produce high quality tea. So that is another major point which you should always include, which is in huge demand throughout the world for both health and social purpose. So I'm including again health and social purpose, which is another important point of that paragraph. So you can write in this way when you are given summarized written text. I have another example for you. So I'll just quickly read this example. With all the discussions about protecting the earth and saving the planet, remember you should always read it in such a way that you can get all those important points, but you should write fast, because if you take too much time, then you will lose time. With all the discussions about protecting the earth and saving the planet, it is easy to forget that we also need to preserve the many species of fish. So it looks like this paragraph is talking about fish that live in the oceans. So from the first sentence, we can say that this paragraph is talking about environment, protection, fish. So again, then in developed countries, much larger quantities of fish are consumed than was the case a century ago, when fish only featured on the menu once a week. So now we can say that this paragraph is more concentrated in the topic of fish. So these days, fish has become a popular, healthy alternative to meat, and this has created a demand for species such as cod, mackerel, tuna that far outstrips the demand of the previous generation. Throughout the world, too, increasing consumption during the past 30 years has meant that the shallow parts of the ocean have been overfished in an effort to supply homes, shops and restaurants with the quantities of fish that they require. Yet despite the sophisticated fishing techniques of today, catches are smaller than they were a century or more ago. What is more, boats are having to drop their nets much deeper into the ocean, and the fish they are coming up with are smaller and way less than they used to. While government controls have had some effect on fish stocks, the future does not offer a promising picture. Experts predict large-scale extinctions and irreversibly damaging effect on entire ecosystems unless greater efforts are made to conserve fish stocks and prevent overfishing in the world's waters. So now I am sure this paragraph is talking about fish, and this paragraph is talking about another topic, another important point, which is that there was not good demand of fish century ago, but now there is a huge demand of fish. So fish is very popular. That is another point. So because fish is popular, overfishing is going on more and more in modern society, modern time. So the population of fish is declining. That's why governments needs to implement some strategies, and there should be some greater efforts from government and other organizations to control the extinction of fish, because fish population is declining, and as fish population is declining, there will be some damaging effect on the ecosystem. So these are the important points from this paragraph. So I have highlighted in red which are the important points of this paragraph. So I'll give you some example of how to write summary. So if I write summary of that paragraph in a simple way or more complex way, I will write like this. So I'm starting with do. So you need to have a good command of the words like do, if, when, how, as long as, if, so, therefore, which will help you to connect those important points. If you don't have good command of this, then it will be difficult to include all those points, because your sentence will be simple, as I already mentioned. So I started with due to the increasing demand of fish. So increasing demand of fish is one point, consequently leading to more overfishing. So I already included two points, which are increasing demand of fish and leading to more overfishing. So those are two points of that paragraph. The world's population of fish is declining. That is another point. So as I already mentioned, it's PTE academic. That means you should focus on academic writing. So if you can make a use of academic words which are somehow sophisticated, then you will always get higher score. If you are focusing for less score, then it won't matter too much. But if you want to get a score which is higher than 79, it's always better to include nice academic and sophisticated words which are used in academic writing, scientific writing. Those words will always help you to improve your words, and that's why it's better to improve your vocabulary. So I started with due, which is important academic words. I also used consequently, which is important academic words. word. Due to the increasing demand of fish, consequently leading to more overfishing, the world's population of fish is declining. Then I'm using so to connect another point. So governmental agencies need to act promptly with greater efforts to protect fish species and prevent irreversible damage of the ecosystem. So this is how you write a summary of that sentence. And if you follow more complex pattern of the sentence, then I can write like this, we can write like this. So compared to many centuries ago, comma, the demand of fish has been increasing day by day. So I'm already including one major point of that paragraph. So compared to many centuries ago, the demand of fish has been increasing day by day. So that means the demand of fish is one important point which I'm covering now. Which has resulted in the rapid decline of fish species throughout the world. So I'm including again another point, because of overfishing. So overfishing is another important point of that paragraph. So I have already included 3 points. So now what I again need to include another important point, which is like greater efforts to protect this species. So now I need to connect that important point. So I'm using another word called therefore. So to use the word like therefore, I need to use semicolon and comma. So therefore, greater efforts to protect these species should be implemented to prevent mass extinction of fish and protect ecosystem. So if you follow this sentence, you can see that I have already included all those important points of that paragraph, and I have also demonstrated my ability to use complex sentence and ability to use the words such as conjunction and complex words and academic words, which will always help me to, which will always enable me to get higher scores in PTE academic. That's how I scored 90 in written discourse, 90 in grammar, and 90 in vocabulary, because I'm using the complex words such as consequently, due, irreversible, therefore, which are nice and sophisticated academic words. So if you want to score higher, you should demonstrate your ability in vocabulary, grammar, and use of complex sentences. Good luck to you all for your exam, and I hope this video will be useful for you, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.